Hey everybody, it's Greg Beckta here, and in this video, I'm going to show you some leaked information for the new Canon EOS R full-frame mirrorless camera, as well as some leaked images. So let's get started. So I have the specs right here, and it looks like an official document to me. The official announcement is going to be September 5th, 2018, but it looks like it's going to be a CMOS sensor, and it's going to be 30 megapixels. Unlike the Nikon, where they had two different versions, it looks like there's just going to be one version of the mirrorless camera, being a 30 megapixel camera. Now, I think the biggest thing about this camera is going to be the autofocus, because that's what everyone loves about Canon. One is the color science, and two is the autofocus features. A lot of people said, well, they thought I was a Nikon guy, so why am I excited about a Canon? Originally, I started on the Canon 5D Mark III in 2013, and I just sold that camera recently. So I've used Canon cameras for photo and video for over 5 years, although I'm using a Nikon D850 right now for my main stills camera. So a little bit more about this. It looks like it's going to have 4K video, but only 29.97, so 30 frames per second. And right now, it's unsure whether it's going to be crop video like the Canon 5D Mark IV. So that's hard to say. And whether it's going to be 10-bit, 422, that's another thing that really isn't out there. There's a lot of information. It looks a lot like a Canon 5D Mark IV without a mirror. That's what it looks like to me as far as the specs. So let's get into some of the specs a little bit more here. You can see this document that I've got here. It's just like a PDF of the spec sheet that you would get when you purchase a camera. It looks like it's only going to have one card slot, which might be a downer, very similar to the Nikon mirrorless cameras. I can get away with one card slot if I had to. Really, I'm looking for a camera that can do both stills and video. Right now, I'm using the Nikon D850 for stills, and I'm using the Panasonic GH5 for video. But it would be nice to have a camera that did all in one. The only downside I find with the Panasonic GH5, well, there's two. One, it's got not the greatest autofocus. So that's kind of a downside of the Panasonic GH5. It'd be nice to have autofocus. It isn't full frame. Now, there's rumors that Panasonic will come out with a full frame, but if they don't have good autofocus, then it's still a problem. So that's one thing that I'm looking at for Canon is the color science and the good autofocus features. And if it could do stills and video all in one, now I could probably live with 30 frames per second of 4K video if it's not cropped. And it looks like it has a flip out screen as well. So you can flip that around just like the Canon 6D or the Panasonic GH5. So it looks like it's going to have some good features. It looks like it could be a winner possibly. It really comes down to the video for me. If it's 4K and it's not cropped and it's 10-bit 422 internal, that would be amazing. So we'll find out on September 5th, but you can see here, it's got one memory card slot, it's got 30 megapixels so far, and then if we get down to the video section here, you can see the different video settings that it has. So it does have 4K, but it looks like it's only going to be at 29.97. So I'll scroll down here, you can see it's going to be MP4, and they're going to have All-I, IPB, and you can see at 4K, it's only 29.97. And then you get full HD, then you get up to 60 frames per second. So that's going to bother a lot of people. And like I said, I can't tell from this whether it's going to be 10-bit 422 internal. I could see here it's 480 mpbs, which sounds very similar to the Canon 5D Mark IV as far as... Canon is kind of known to kind of make the video features not as robust as they could, so they don't interfere with their higher line of video cameras. So they might keep that trend going. So that could be a downside. Also, there's going to be a number of different lenses. Petapixel.com has a pretty good article here with some specs and leaked images. You can see this is what they're saying is the leaked images for the Canon EOS R. It looks a little odd to me, but you'll see one here where it compares it to an existing DSLR body. It's quite a lot smaller. If this fits in your hand comfortably, it is going to be a savings of weight and size, definitely. You'll need an adapter for your existing Canon lenses, it looks like. And you can see here on launch, it seems as if they're going to have a 35-1.8, a 50-1.2, a 28-70 f2, which is kind of strange. Maybe that's a typo. I thought it was supposed to be a 24-70, and then it looks like there's going to be a 24-105 f4. September 5th, I'll give you the official update, but this looks like it's pretty reliable at this stage, and more about that on September 5th.